Could Great Salt Lake dust be harming your health and your bank account?
If we add up all of those emergency department visits, what is the cost?
One University of Utah assistant professor is tallying up the price Utahns could pay living next to the shrinking Great Salt Lake.
We're trying to translate the impacts of these dust emissions.
I'm Lauren Steinbrecher with PBS Utah. We've been reporting on Great Salt Lake dust research here at the University of Utah, from on-the-ground studies to a dust forecasting model to data showing who is most impacted. And this brand new research project is showing what ways that dust could hit our economy.
Dr. Albert Garcia first looked at where Great Salt Lake dust is blowing.
So you can see which areas are experiencing the most dust exposure. So these really dark areas.
Breaking down demographics in those areas to figure out who is at risk of getting sick from dust storms.
For example, if there's a really young population, that's maybe where we expect more of those asthma symptoms.
Then he computed cost from predicted health outcomes, like missing work or school, or an increase in medical bills from trips to the ER.
Saying, what's the average charge of an asthma-induced emergency department visit?
Garcia added in the impact from people estimated to die prematurely from the health problems related to dust, which he explains can be boiled down to numbers.
We use a measure called value of a statistical life.
According to all those calculations, here's what Great Salt Lake dust could cost the local economy.
Annually, we think that the effects of dust right now are around, $30 million, but we expect those to rise.
And over the course of the next 20 years, Garcia says negative health outcomes could set the Salt Lake community back $1 billion.
No one's really surprised that the dust causes asthma or leads to some premature mortality, but I think what we're really learning is the magnitude of those effects.
By connecting dust emissions and the economy, Garcia's goal is to help build understanding of the problem as Utah searches for answers.
I think that's what can be really useful to policymakers, is understanding exactly how big is this issue.
Head to the PBS Utah YouTube page to see our full piece on Great Salt Lake dust, health, and how the community moves forward. And stay up to date on local topics at pbsutah.org/UtahInsight.